I thought it was all lost. I just lost my mom and dad last year. This has been too much. So anyway, but we're okay. That's what I care about.
For the last 6 months, Shirley Silifen and her husband called the Fairfield Inn home.
I go out 1 hour, take him to the chiropractor around the corner. We're coming back on my way to Starbucks, and I look up, and there's this black billowing smoke. And I said, oh my God, Lee, I think that could be our hotel.
Employees tell us just before noon, an air conditioning unit on the roof started smoking and sparking. They tried to hold it back with fire extinguishers while guests evacuated.
So I pulled our alarm and I started knocking on every single door, and then the deputy showed up and helped me go door knocking.
The flames quickly took over the attic, sending thick black smoke billowing out. The roof started to collapse, forcing fire crews back.
Due to the increased temperatures, our guys are getting, let's just say, beat up rather quickly. So once they come out, we're rotating them in with fresh crews.
We just, you know, stood outside and just watched the flames start going through our roof where we call home, because we all been working here for so long.
Everyone got out okay, miraculous, considering people occupied every one of the 112 rooms the night before.
I think this is a tragedy, but I think they are very fortunate that Stagecoach is over, and I imagine everybody checked out at the right time.
The older hotel just went through a complete renovation, including a new sprinkler system. The fire started on the roof above the sprinklers.
Our room is lost. I was afraid it was. I can see now.
The Silifen stayed on the third floor, right where the fire did most of the damage.
Everything is in that room other than our car. We've got our car, and I've got my handbag. I've got some ID, so we're okay. He wasn't behind, and that's all I care about, that I was with him.